You can't start off the year without a list of predictions, especially in tech. So it's 2022, we're gonna kick off the year properly with a list of Eli's technology predictions and trends. Let's get started. Welcome back to Pluralsight's Head in the Cloud, everyone. My name's Elias Khnaser, and in today's episode, we're going to answer the question, what are the technology predicts and trends for 2022. Now, if you like this type of content, don't forget to like, subscribe, share, hit that notification button so that you're alerted the next time we upload a video. And don't forget to visit pluralsight.com and check out the library of IT courses, developer courses, operations courses. There's a ton of courses, whether it's for yourself or for your team, to kickstart this year properly and make sure that you and your team are properly skilled and ready for all of the different trends and predictions that we're gonna go through. Without further ado, prediction number one, the edge is the next frontier. Now that doesn't mean that we're not gonna continue to do a lot of cloud. On the contrary, cloud has become essentially a de facto standard, but we're gonna focus a lot more on the edge. And what better way to start off the year than with an even more confusing term than cloud, edge. Well, which edge, Eli? There's the near edge, there's the far edge, there's the network edge, there's Internet of Things, there's the remote office edge. Which edge are we talking about? So all of these are valid, and every organization is going to be doing one or more of these edges. So having an edge strategy is going to be crucial. Keep an eye on this channel. We're going to be publishing more of this type of content regarding how to build an edge strategy. But I want to focus in on a few specific edges here. And the first one is distributed cloud. Distributed cloud is the process of bringing the public cloud providers on premises. Now, we've seen services from AWS like AWS Outposts, like Azure Stack. Microsoft has a ton in the form of hybrid, especially with Arc services and others. Google has Anthos. So the ability to bring these like-for-like technologies and create a true hybrid cloud experience on premises, that is going to be in focus. These products have been around for a few years, but they are finally at a level of maturity where organizations are going to start adopting them. Another trend when it comes to the edge that's going to be very popular is going to be application delivery networks, or ADN. Now, when you think of ADN, think of Lambda meets CloudFront. So in other words, we're talking about serverless or functions on top of a CDN, for example, like Akamai. In Azure's case, think of, for example, Azure Functions meets Azure CDN. These are the types of things, and we're going to be doing these at the edge. All of these are going to become a very interconnected environment. Prediction number two, intent-based platforms. Eli, what the heck's an intent-based platform? Well, some of us would call this intelligent infrastructure, but it's above and beyond really intelligent infrastructure. An intent-based platform is where all of the infrastructure that you deploy on this platform has an API, can be addressed via API. So APIs everywhere. An intent-based platform will require fanatical automation. So I'm talking infrastructure as code. Everything is automated. Everything is talking via API or some other way, but the automation becomes the center of this intent-based platform. So think of Terraform, think of Ansible, think of all of these tools that you can leverage to build fanatical automation onto this platform. But it doesn't stop there. Now we also need an intelligence layer on top of this platform. This intelligence layer is going to be responsible for doing things like making sure that the application is self-sufficient. The application is able to control the infrastructure, meaning if the application requires more RAM, the application is going to request more RAM. If the application requires more storage, more network, more CPU, it's able to calibrate itself using this new platform. The intelligence also comes into the form of self-healing. So if there's a hard drive that's failing, we want to be able to take measures to fix this hardware before it actually disrupts something. Prediction number three, cloud outages are going to be in focus in 2022, and they're going to be in focus in a variety of ways. I think, again, the events of December 2021 highlighted that, you know, any environment is going to have outages. And let's just be honest about this for a second. There were several outages, but sometimes things do happen. That has to be factored in. I once talked to a customer. We were talking about a DR strategy, and no matter what I threw at this customer, the customer said, well, what if that failed? What if that failed? What if that? I mean, I was throwing the kitchen sink, right? At one point, I'm like, sir, I mean, with all due respect, at the end of the day, Earth is a single point of failure. There's only so much you can say, well, what if that fails and what if that fails? organizations are going to be looking at, well, what can we do, right? So multi-cloud is going to be in focus. Multiple regions within the same cloud provider are going to be in focus. Distributed cloud is going to be in focus. This hybrid architecture nature of what we're doing is certainly going to be in focus. I also think that we are going to be at the beginning of government regulation. They've become like the railroads in the 1800s, where they're the livelihood of the economy. Today, if these public cloud providers have an extended outage, the economy comes to a halt. The economy stops. And I think we're going to be at the beginning of classifying them as critical infrastructure, maybe even too big to fail. We're also going to see renewed interest in cyber insurance. Now, some of these cloud providers already offer some form of cyber insurance. Look at what Google is doing. I think the program is still in beta, but we're going to see an expansion of other third-party providers that are offering this type of cyber insurance. Now, I wanted to make a predict on DevOps, but I thought it's going a little too far and it could be misunderstood. So I'm going to put it in the form of a recommendation. Whether it's for yourself or for your team, we should stop freaking out about the word DevOps. Technically, when you really drill down into it, DevOps is all about understanding how to automate things, whether it's infrastructure as code, whether it's things like Terraform and Ansible and Puppet and Chef and Python and cloud development kits. So one of the things that I would recommend to you if you're a manager and you wanted to invest in upskilling your team, the first questions I would ask in 2022 is, how many of you know Terraform? Do they know what a cloud development kit is, a CDK? Ask them that question. Do they know basics of Python? We don't need to be a full stack developer. That's the wrong way to think of DevOps. But we certainly need to know how to code. Now, when I say that, sometimes infrastructure operations folks, you know, take a step back and like, what is this? Hey folks, it's not new. We've always been doing this in our career. It's just learning a new tool, learning what immutability means. Ask them what observability is. If they don't, make sure they go and they research this. Again, make sure you check out pluralsight.com for recommendations on a lot of these courses. DevOps has come to a point where it means everything and it means nothing. So we are going to actually give DevOps a meaning. Think of DevOps within the framework of automation, within the framework of fanatical automation, infrastructure as code, Puppet, Chef, Ansible, Terraform. All of these things are the tools that you or your team should be looking at this year. That's my list. The edge is going to be the next frontier. Intent-based platforms. Cloud outages are going to be in focus. And then my recommendation about simplifying DevOps and learning fanatical automation. I hope all of my list, all of my trends come true this year. I hope you found this information useful. If you did, give me a thumbs up, subscribe, like, share, hit that notification bell. Thank you so much for watching to the end. I love you all, and I'll see you in the next one.